This conference will now be recorded.
So can I call humans also one species? How many of you studied biology in PUC? Yeah, so many. I didn't study the biology. I just done my diploma. I did not done PUC. Yeah, humans are also a type of species, right? Animals are also. Okay, let's come to the example. Now, objects will be having what? Objects will be having what? Properties and behaviors. Properties and behaviors. Now, all the properties I'm representing in the form of this string name, int age, string color, double weight. The behavior I'm representing in the form of methods. Some animal barks, some animal it is roar, it will be roaring. Some animal will be howls. Some animal will be speak. So now I'll be creating an object. Okay. Dog. D1 equals new D. I'm creating an object for dog. Animal dog. Right. Now, using the reference variable, I'm setting the name of the dog. What is the name of the dog? Age. I'm setting it to 6. Weight. I'm setting it to something like 15.5. Then color is black. Now I'm calling D1 dot bark. Is it fine? D1 dot bark. D1 dot name age. Weight, color, then after that bark, I'm calling bark, class animal. Desktop animal. animal. So what will be the output? Sorry. 90. Yeah, what will be the output? What will be the output? Now, whenever we are creating an object, all the non-static members will be getting loaded to the memory with their default values. If I don't want the default values, I can assign it to the new value. I'm setting the d1.name. D1 is of type dog. D1 is of type dog. Now, observe here, I cannot just say dog. Why? Because the class name is animal. I need to give animal. Okay, animal. Animal. Here, dog. Dog. Okay. Dog, let's say dog one. Dog one. Dog one. Dog one. Now we'll be getting name as John 6, 15.5, black, and this animal barks. This animal barks. This is the behavior of this object. All these are properties. Properties of this object, dog one object. We are getting John 6, 15.5, black, this animal barks. Now I want to create an object for human. Name. Age. Then color. Then what I'm doing here is system dot out dot println human one dot name age weight color age weight. Then here I'm calling speaks So what are we getting? Smith 26, 60.5, why this animal speaks. So objects will be having properties and behaviors. Yesterday we have seen in the Python, similar. But syntax is different. Syntax is different. This is a reference variable. This is I'm creating an object. This is the class name, class definition. Using a reference variable, I'm calling x. This is the property of class, my class. X is the property of my class. I'm creating a variable called p1. I'm assigning an object, my class. What we will get? What we will get? We'll get 5 as the output. Yesterday, who are Arjun? Develop this. So what is INIT? Double underscore. That is not single underscore, double underscore, INIT, double underscore. Next, self, comma, name, comma, age. INIT is the built-in function in the Python. INIT, that is the built-in function in the Python that is similar to constructor in the Java. That is similar to constructor in the Java. Now, whenever we are initializing an object, at the time that INIT function will be executing. To set the values for the properties of that object, So what is self? Self will be pointing to the current object of the class. Okay, it is similar to this in Java. This keyword is there. Similar to this. It will be pointing to the current instance of the class. Current object of the class. It doesn't have to be self. I can name it anything I want. It doesn't have to be self. We can name it anything we want. And that should be the first parameter in any function. Now, in INIT, we have three parameters. In INIT function, we have three parameters. Self or whatever that will be pointing to the current object parameter, that should be the first argument. In any function. Follow the proper indentation, otherwise you'll be getting error. Follow the indentation. But the output. Develop this one. Everybody getting the output? Develop this one. How to change the value of the property? how to change the property of an object. I'm changing the value. Changing the property value of an object. Getting the output. Object, how to delete the property of an object by using del. By using del, how to delete a property of an object. How to delete the property of an object. In this line, we'll be getting error.
Understood?
How can I use DL to delete a property of an object? I'm deleting age property of person class. How to delete an object? How to delete an object itself? How to delete an object itself? Not the property, object itself. How to delete an object? Understood? How to delete an object itself? Next, file handling. How to work with files in case of how to working with file. Write down these things. Open is a function, then R stands for read, A for append, W is writing purpose, X for creating. Other than this, we have text, that is the default, and the binary mode. Text mode and binary mode. Then observe here, f is equal to open demo file.txt. I'm sending and giving R reading purpose. Now create a file called demo file. Okay, create a file called demo file in the same folder which you are saving this file. The same folder which you are saving this Python file, text file. Okay, write something in that text file. Save as demo file. Extension should be .txt. Don't give .txt if you are already opening text file. If you are opening text file, don't give .txt. It is already a text file. Create a file called demo file. TXT file, text file. Enter some content. You got see one create one text file within the same folder which you are saving this Python file. Okay, create a text file. New, click on right click on new. Yeah, observe, right click, new. Okay, create text document. Okay, if it is there, that is fine. If it is not, when you are saving, give the .txt extension. develop an X2 program make some small change provide t r and t r is for reading purpose t is for text that is the default value if I don't give also that is fine If we don't give also, that is fine. Now, how to read a part of the file? How to read a part of the file? Instead of reading the whole content of the file, if I need to specifically read the part of the file, now I just want to only return 5 characters that is available in that text file. How can I do that? I just want to return only 5 characters that is in the text file. By default read method will be returning the all the contents whatever it is there okay whatever the content it is there in the text that will be returning if I want to read a specific part of the file or if I want to read only 5 characters let's say in this case I need to read only 5 characters. Yeah, count also it will. Observe 5 characters 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Now, what is the content I have in the text file? This is the content I have. Python is awesome. Okay. Now, what is the total length of this? Maybe 17 total length. 17. Let's say 17. Are we getting the whole text? We are getting the whole text. If I want to read specific number of characters if I want to read specific number of characters space, it is also it is counting. Observe, space, it is also considering as one character. Okay. Now let me modify this file. Okay, I made some changes to the text file. Now we have two lines. How to read a particular line, how to read the contents of develop this. Read line. Instead of returning the whole content, I'm just returning a line. Yes. Let's say here once again. Now we'll be returning two lines. It will be returning two lines of that particular file. Two lines. Now, there is another way. There is another way to print the whole content of the file. There is another way to print the whole content of the file. What is that? You are supplying here values. Yeah, okay. And for the second line, read line 3. Read line 2, 3. Let's observe here. I'm giving this as. Are we getting now? For the second line? First line, it is reading whatever it is there. So for the second line, it is printing two characters. Now for the, if I want to print some of the first line, So observe here, the first read line, what it is returning? PY. Okay. So the pointer will be, it will be printing P and Y, then it will be pointing to P of the same line. The next line, what I'm doing, trying to print the entire line. It will be printing entire line. Okay, finished. First line is finished, printed. Next, second line. It will be pointing to the second line. Second line. We are getting JA from the second line. We are getting JA from the second line. Now, if I remove this, what happens? There are no lines left. We will once again, what is it is doing? See. After printing JA, it will be pointing to V. Then if I try to print read line, it will be printing the whole line, remaining whole line, remaining whole line. If I after also, if I try to print, what happens? There are no lines, just see, observe this space. Space is there. Space is added. White spaces. There is another way to read entire line, entire content. Develop this. looping through the contents of the file by using for loop. Looping through the contents of the file using for loop. It is similar to whatever we are achieving through the read line method, the same we are achieving through this for loop. So next, how to close a file. So we opened a file for reading purpose. How to close? It is necessity. It is the It is necessary to close file after opening. Okay. If I don't close the file, we don't get the changes what we have made. So after finishing our task, we need to close the file. After finishing our task, whatever reading or writing operation has done, then after that we need to close the file. How to close the file? After reading, just f.close. It is necessary to close a file after all the operations has been done. Now we'll see how to write to a file. How to write to a file. So what does A means? You have written, right? So it will be appending to the end of the file. What is W means? It will be overwriting the existing content, whatever it is there inside the text file, that will be overwritten by the content what you are providing. Observe. F is equal to open. I need to use this to open the file. What is the name of the file? What is the name of the file? Demo file. Demo file. .txt extension. So here, what I'm supplying, append. Append in the sense it will be appending to the end of the file. Whatever the content is there will be there. After all the contents, it will be appending whatever I'm providing. F dot write. After finishing our operation, it is good practice to close the file. Then if I want to read the content after appending, demo file dot txt. Now for what purpose I'm opening? For reading purpose. So print f dot read. So here save the file. Save as app to demo file save. Okay. How to write a file? Observe here. It is saved inside the app too. I have only Python is awesome, Java is super awesome content. Now I'm executing this, writing the file. Observe. That is demo. Demo. Okay. Observe. Now check the content. Check the content. See, the file has been written. So it is asking to once again for loading. Okay, the file has been written by the Python interpreter. The file has been written by the Python interpreter. Now the edit plus is asking to load once again. If I click on yes, we'll be getting the content. Now if I try to open the same file, we'll be getting this content. Now the file is having more content. But the thing is, why we are getting two times? What if I run once again? Observe. Now I'll be having observe. Now, how to overwrite? Now we have seen the append. How to append we have seen at the end of the file. Now how to overwrite? Already existing content will be overriding with the new content. How to overwrite? Here I'll be giving W.
Thank you.
develop a next program, how to create a new file. How to create a new file. I don't have any file with the name myfile.txt. So create, it will be creating a new file. If the my file is already existing in the current folder, it will be throwing an error. That is, file already exists. If the file, it is already exists, which I'm creating by using X. Otherwise, it will be creating new file. File name is my file. Extension is .txt. What happened? Observe. Check whether that file is created or not. My file is created. Myfile.txt. Now this is one way. This is one way of creating. Another way. We'll see the another way. Instead of X, I'll be giving A. If the file does not exist, see, observe, I'm giving this one as this file. My file is already existing, so that is why I'm giving this file. This file. Name of the file is this file. I can also create a file using X and A. If the file is already existing, we'll be getting error in case of X. If the file is already existing in case of A, that will be appending to the end of the file. Content will be appending to the end of the file. Now, this is another way to create a file. Now, there is another way, is there? One more way. One more way is there. One more way. How to create a file? Here I'm providing w. It will be writing. in this case also we'll be creating new file. The name of the file is that file. Now we'll see how to delete a file. We'll see how to delete a file. Now, in order to achieve delete, we must import one module. We must import one module, that is import OS. OS dot remove. I'll be removing this file dot txt. Save this file. To delete a file, I must import OS module. To import the OS module, I'm using import OS, and I should run the function of OS module, that is os.remove. That is os.remove. I need to run the function of OS module before, if I want to remove or delete a file, I want to import the OS module, import OS, and then I need to run the function of OS module, that is os.remove. os.remove. In the current folder, we have this file dot txt. In the current folder, we have this file dot txt. Now, after running this program, check the folder. Check the folder. This file is gone. This file has been removed. This file has been removed. Earlier there were three files. One of the file is this file. Now using os.remove, I removed this file. Now before removing, if I want to check whether that particular file is available or not, that is to avoid the error, right? To avoid the exception, right? To avoid the runtime error, first I need to make sure that that particular file is existing. Now how can I do that? That particular file, whether it is existing or not. Import OS. If OS dot path dot exists, so I'll be giving whatever it other than whatever the files are present. I'll be giving other file dot txt. It is not present in my folder. It is not present. Follow the proper indentation, otherwise you'll be getting error. I'm checking whether the other file.txt, if it is existing or not. If it is existing, it will be calling os.remove. If it is not executing the else part, else the file does not exist. We are expecting now the message, the file does not exist. Why? Because the other file.txt, it is not present in the folder. Run, we are getting the file does not exist. The file does not exist. Now, how to remove a directory? What is directory? Folder. How can I remove the folder? Let me create a folder called a new folder. The name of the folder will be new folder. Okay, how to delete a directory? How to delete a folder? In order to do that, I need to first import the OS module, os.rmdir. What is that means? What is that means? Rmdir. Rm stands for remove, dir stands for remove directory. So new folder. If I run this, the system cannot find the file, new folder. Just try to make sure to provide the same name, in the sense, capital letter F, also it is the capital letter, then try to run. Now itself it is not finding. Now a new folder, empty folder. New folder. Okay. So how to remove? How to remove? Now I'll be naming this folder as my folder. My folder. Yes, check it out now. My folder directory has been deleted. Instead of giving the new folder, just try to give any other name. Maybe another two classes of Python, that's it for you guys, for JSP batch. Another two classes Python will get over, then we'll be starting SQL. Before that, let me finish C also. Is there? Let me finish C. Okay. then we'll move on to SQL. Okay. Practice all this. We'll continue tomorrow.